Assalamu alaikum students, this is Ms. Leila Hassan. I hope you're safe and sound at your home and you're completing your assigned task on regular basis. This video is being made to solve one of the query which was asked by me by one of the students, and the query is regarding the inequality, page number 23 of supplemental material. The question is question number 3, and it is part I. Part I says that minus 6, 4x is greater than minus 6 and 4x is lesser than equals to 8. Now see, this is what I have written in a very in a bigger font in front of you. And first of all, we are going to finalize and we are going to ascertain it, that what kind of algebraic, either it is a term, it is an equation, it is an inequality, what it is, and how are we going to recognize this. First of all, it is not an algebraic term, it is not an algebraic equation, however it is an inequality. How do we recognize that this is an inequality? By the use of these signs. It does not contain any is equals to sign, that's why it has a greater than sign, and it has a lesser than equals to sign, which means people, if this kind of signs are present in an algebraic, then it is an inequality. Now how are we going to read this? Now see, this 4x is written in the middle, right? So we are going to read in such a manner that 4x and this sign is actually opening towards 4x, right? So how are we going to read it? That 4x is greater than minus 6, but this 4x is lesser than equals to 8. Now this is how we are going to read up this inequality. Now the steps which we are going to follow to solve is to first isolate this variable with this coefficient. Let me write it down for your convenience as well. Step one is to isolate. Isolate means to make this variable only stand alone, without any coefficient, without any constant added or subtracted to it. Okay, isolate the variable with coefficient. With coefficient by multiplying or divide. Now how are we going to do this? Now see, the coefficient which is multiplied with this variable which is x is 4. So what are we going to do? We are going to divide 4 with each of these 3. This, we have a constant over here, we have a constant over here, and we have a term over here. So we are going to divide 4 with each 3 of these. So minus 6 divided by 4, then this sign, 4x divided by 4, the sign of lesser than equals to 8 divided by 4. Yes, now what are we going to do? We are going to do the cancellation individually. 3 2's are 6 and 3 2's are 4, or 2 2's are 4, 4 1's are 4, 4 1's are 4, 4 1's are 4, and 4 2's are 8. Now see, 3 divided by 2, if we take out a decimal number, it is 1.5, as we all know this. And now here, see, only x is left and we have isolated this x. Now let's complete this inequality. Completion is the utmost necessary task. We have to complete what we have started. Now see, how are we going to read this? We're going to read this in such a manner that this x is greater than minus 1.5. It is not greater than equals to, because we don't have that sign over here. X is greater than minus 1.5. And it is lesser than equals to, because we have only this pointed sign towards x, which means x is lesser than equals to 2. Okay, this is how we are going to read it. So we will actually be obtaining a range of x, which will be including different numbers. Now let's see that on a number line. In middle we have a 0, over here we have 1, and over we have 2. However, here minus 1, and over here minus 2. So in middle of minus 1 and minus 2, we have got minus 1.5, and 2 is over here. So we are going to make a circle over minus 1.5. Why we are not going to color the circle? Because we have only a greater than sign. That's why we are not coloring it. Now we are going to extend a line till this 2, and we are going to color this 2. Why are we coloring this 2? Because we have a sign which is saying that x is lesser than equals to 2. So all of these numbers that is ranging between minus 1.5 till 2, that shall be included and that shall be regarded as an x. So x is greater than minus 1.5, so the value that is greater than minus 1.5 will be x till 2. So all of these numbers that are coming within this range, that pertains to x, and x will be having all of these numbers within this range. Minus 1.5 will not be equals to x because x is greater than minus 1.5. I hope your query has been solved regarding this part. In next video, I shall be uploading the solution for question number 3, part L as well. Good luck.